In this lecture, we are going to see the topic the diagonalization of language, unit 5. So that will start with non-self-accepting language and self-accepting language, NSA and SA. So non-self-accepting language is known as for a Turing machine which does not accept the particular input string that does not belong to the language. So that language is called as non-self-accepting language, is denoted by NSA, and NSA is a not recursive, which means it is a recursive enumerable language, and it is also not recursive enumerable because the Turing machine, there is no Turing machine to accept the particular input string which does not belong to the language. So, and it is also the complement of self-accepting language, it is denoted by SA. Next one is self-accepting language, SA. So SA is a language that accepts its own encoding scheme, and also for a Turing machine which accepts the input string W which belongs to the particular language. So that particular or that type of language is called as self-accepting language. So SA is equal to W belongs to 0,1 the whole star. So for the Turing machine, M and W belongs to the particular Turing machine, that is L of M. So it is the language containing the input string W, which is the code of the Turing machine that accepts its own encoding. So this is the difference between SA and NSA. So for SA, the Turing machine accepts the input string which belongs to the particular language. For NSA, it does not accept the input string which does not belong to the language. So from this self-accepting and non-self-accepting language, there is one theorem. The theorem is NSA is not recursive enumerable. Non-self-accepting language is not recursive enumerable. We know what is recursive enumerable. The Turing machine accepts the input string which belongs to the particular language. The Turing machine does not accept the input string which does not belong to the language, and also it goes to the infinite loop. That language is called as recursively enumerable language. So by proving this theorem, for any Turing machine capital M, we are assuming the string W is equal to E of M. E is an element of the particular language of NSA if W is not accepted by M. So from this, W is equal to E of M is an element of NSA if and only if that particular input string is accepted by the Turing machine. Since there is no Turing machine for accepting NSA, it is not recursive enumerable. So this is the first theorem. So the second theorem is the language SA, self-accepting language, is recursive enumerable but not recursive. So you can clearly understand that SA is recursive enumerable and NSA is not recursively enumerable. So by proving this, we are assuming one Turing machine capital M. So W is equal to E of M. E is an element of the particular Turing machine. It leads to fails to accept the particular input string for a Turing machine and going to the infinite loop or loops forever. So for a Turing machine, it accepts the particular input string if the particular input string which does not belong to the language of that machine, then that machine goes to the infinite loop or loops forever. That is the first diagram. Consider the second diagram. If the particular input string belongs to the particular language, then the Turing machine will halt or stop the operation with the answer of yes, either or no. So the Turing machine first tests the input string W if W is equal to E of M. If the particular condition is satisfied, then the Turing machine accepts the input string and halt all their operation. So this is the second theorem. So from the above theorem, we can know that NSA is not recursive enumerable. SA is recursive enumerable. SA is self-accepting language. NSA is non-self-accepting language. So recursive language and recursive enumerable language or unsolvable problem. So the self-accepting language and non-self-accepting language. So NSA is defined by the particular input string which belongs to the input 0, 1 with 0 or more times for some Turing machine, and that particular input string does not belong to the language of that Turing machine. That is NSA. So what is SA? It is defined by the input string belongs to 0, 1 with 0 or more times for some Turing machine, and that input string belongs to the language of that particular Turing machine. So for a non-self-accepting language, there is no Turing machine to accept it. So the two languages, SA and NSA, are complement with each other. So what is recursive and what is recursive enumerable language, already we know. If the problem solved by the Turing machine, that problem can be classified into two classes. One is the problem should have some algorithm, and the problem are only solved by the particular Turing machine. In the first case, the Turing machine halt whether or not it accepts its input. In the second case, the Turing machine may run forever on the input that don't accept the particular input string. So shortly we can say that the problem can be divided into two classes. One is decidable and undecidable. So for each and every decidable problem having some algorithm to accept the input to produce a solution, either yes or no. So for undecidable problem, we don't have any algorithm and we can't easily determine whether the solution is either yes or no. That is undecidable. So a language is recursive if there existing a Turing machine capital M which accepts every string W of the language and rejects the string which is not belongs to the language. So it return the answer is either yes or no, but the Turing machine will always halt with either yes or no. So a language is recursive enumerable if there existing a Turing machine that accept every string of the language which or belongs to the particular input string and does not accept the string that or not belongs to the particular language, which means if the particular input string does not belong to the language, then the Turing machine goes to the infinite loop or loops forever, which means the Turing machine will never halt for the particular input string which does not belong to the language. The Turing machine will only halt if the only halt for the particular input string which is belong to the particular language. So this is the relationship diagram between recursive enumerable and recursive language. So all recursive language is called as not recursive and recursive enumerable language. But not all not recursive enumerable language is recursive. It is a complement. Recursive and recursive enumerable is complement, and recursive enumerable is otherwise called as not recursive. So all recursive language is known as recursive enumerable language, but not all recursive enumerable language is recursive language. But the condition is some of the recursive enumerable languages recursive. This is the relationship diagram between recursive and recursive enumerable language. So the new concept is the diagonalization of language. We know the term diagonal. So in Turing machine, some of the integers or some of the strings don't belong to any Turing machine. So consider W is an input string. So WI is not a valid Turing machine code. Not a valid Turing machine code means the particular input string W does not belong to any language, so that input string WI is not accepted by any Turing machine. That's why that code is called as a not valid Turing machine code. So then take the Turing machine MI to be the Turing machine. So we have to design one Turing machine with one state. So there is only one state for a Turing machine. So in default, there is no transitions to be occurred or performed in that particular one state, because there is only one state for a machine. So there is no transition to be performed on that single state. So this Turing machine MI is specially designed for that MI not valid Turing machine code. So for these values of WI, MI is a Turing machine that halts on any input, because MI is designed based on only one state. So if any input to pass to that particular particular Turing machine MI, it immediately halt for any input string. So it can be defined L of M of mi, that is language of that Turing machine, is equal to 5 if wi is not a valid Turing machine code. So this is the definition of diagonalization language. From this we can derive the diagonalization language ld is the set of strings wi where wi is not a valid Turing machine code, is otherwise we can write it as mi does not accept wi. Wi is not a valid Turing machine code, or mi, Turing machine, does not accept wi. So ld consists of all the strings w such that the Turing machine whose code is w does not accept the input w, because we are designing only the Turing machine for the input string which are not accepted by any Turing machine, or the particular input string is not a valid Turing machine code. For that type of code only the Turing machine MA is designed. So language of MA is equal to 5 if and only the WI is not a valid Turing machine code, or otherwise MI, Turing machine, does not accept WI. So this is the diagrammatic format of diagonalization language. You can see that it is a pair of element. In horizontal they are writing the element for J 1, 2, 3, 4, and in vertical for I value 1, 2, 3, 4. So in diagonal the values are 0, 0, 0, 1. So this is the diagonal value we know, right? So it is clear that whether the Turing machine MI accepts the input string WI or not, there are two conditions. The conditions are if I, J, it is a pair, so is equal to 1. 1 means yes, it is accepted. If the pair value is 0, then it indicates the result is no, which means it is rejected, reject the particular input string. So from this diagonalization of language, there is one theorem. The theorem is LD is not recursive enumerable language. So diagonalization of language is denoted by L suffix D. L is language, D is diagonalization. So LD is diagonalization of language. So the theorem is LD is not recursively enumerable. So we will start with, there is no Turing machine that accept LD, because LD is a set of input string WI if WI is not a valid Turing machine code. In the case of WI is not a valid Turing machine code, then there is no Turing machine to occur to accept that particular input string WI. So there is no Turing machine appeared that accept LD. So to prove the theorem, we can assume two cases, and we can prove the theorem by writing the definition of diagonalization of language. LD is equal to WI and WI is not a valid Turing machine code, or MI does not accept WI. So there are two possibility of cases for recursive enumerable, because we are going to prove LD is not recursive enumerable. So for proving not recursive enumerable, there is two cases. The case is the first case is if the input string belongs to the particular language, or the input string does not belong to the particular language. There are two cases. So the first case is WI belongs to LD. So WI is a set of strings which are belong to LD, means diagonalization of language. This is first case. So second case is WI is does not belongs to LD. So we will start with first case. So in the first case, this statement refers that MI does not accept WI. The Turing machine does not accept WI. But our assumption is here that there exists a Turing machine MI which accepts WI. So from this two statement, there is a contradiction. You can see that in the first step, Turing machine accept WI. Second step, Turing machine accept WI. In the first step also, first line also, MI does not accept WI. So there is some contradiction. So the first case is not true. The first statement leads to false. So the second case is this statement refers as MI accept WI, because WI does not belong to LD means MI, Turing machine accept WI. But by the definition of LD, MI does not accept WI. Here also there is some contradiction, because you can clearly see that in the first line MI accept WI. In the second line, MI does not accept WI. So there is some contradiction in the statement. So from this, the second case is also false. So the two possible cases or leads to false statement. That's why the LD is not recursive enumerable, and also LD is not recursive too. So these are the concept of diagonalization language. So in this lecture we saw about what is recursive language, what is recursive enumerable language, decidable problem, undecidable problem, solvable problem and unsolvable problem, and self-accepting language SA and non-self-accepting language NSA. Then diagonalization of language. So there is one theorem, that is LD is not recursive enumerable, but by the end of that theorem we know that LD is not recursive enumerable and also not recursive too.